Namaste, my friends. This is Wolfgang with Tools for Ascension, and today we will be talking how to heal yourself with rose quartz and other pink stones. So for the best rose quartz, the pinker it is, the better it is. This here is a strawberry rose quartz, which actually projects a holographic cross when it's polished. This is some of the finest rose quartz you can get, and, but I like to combine it with a rhodochrosite. Here you have a rhodochrosite. You can see the rings. A rhodochrosite has beautiful pink variations, and it does very well with rose quartz. And here I'm having a ruby crystal. This is your natural shape at which ruby forms. And ruby is a wonderful stone to carry any energy into the blood, so I like to combine this with my pink. And of course there are other beautiful tools. Like here I have pink salt, you know, into which you can put a candle. It also emanates the color of love, and so in principle, you know, they all work the same. You know, they especially work on the heart chakra, which is the energy center that is here, and actually also the higher heart centers that are along the sternum. And they will help us receive the color of love, the color of healing, and pink. And these stones can be used in different configurations. Like you can piggyback them onto a crystal. Like I would have my hands just with the pink stone, use the crystal as a projector and project the energy, the combined energy through the crystal onto the person, onto the object. But you could also, if you have like a singing bowl, especially the larger ones, putting pink stone into it is just a wonderful feeling. Try it without, try it with pink stones, and you will know the difference. You can use, and I do this for myself a lot, use them in combination with the wand. Just hold the pink stones in your hand and just project the energy through the wand, and it will be beautiful pink energy. And another nice way of using pink, of course everything is in combination, just like spices. So let's say here I have my divine symbol, and which jacks up everything or brings into a higher vibration anything you put onto it. And then here I have a crystal where you can insert a tea light. So I put this together, and so this crystal then here starts projecting a beautiful energy, and you can either put the pink stones into the hole here, or place them somewhere on the crystal, and then when you ignite the tea light, it will amplify it even more, because fire is a thought form amplifier, or it's an amplifier in general. And when you ask them nicely, please shower us with love, it will be even stronger. Now that we have gone over color combinations, let us consider some general principles that I have explained in other videos. But that are essential to understanding this video here. First of all, we will be smiling a lot. Without smiling, basically, it is very, very difficult to manifest love. The smile is the expression of love. It is the perfect mudra of love. If you know anything about mudras, I would say the most important one is the smile. Also, the other principle is that we use chi or life force or prana or ki or vril. They're all different names for the same principle or for the same phenomena. And we project this, actually we take it from heaven on earth, you know, through the crown chakra or through the root chakra and through the legs into ourselves. We draw it into ourselves with a smile, and then we project it, you know, on the exhale. Basically, you just imagine that this love flows, you know, through our arms or through our hand into the stone, and amplifies the properties of that stone, just like a transistor amplifies and modifies the raw energy of electricity that is given into it. And then, you know, there's a smaller current that modulates this energy. That's how a transistor is an amplifier. And in the same way, the small modifying principle is here the pinkness of the stone, and in a way also the matrix, the way in which the atoms are arranged. So the stronger you inhale and draw the energy into yourself, the more you smile, the better the quality will be of the energy that is coming out of the stone. Now, in healing, there are also different ways how you can apply energy and the stone. You could lay them on your body, which I do a lot in my bathtub, or with people that are relatively pure. Let's say I have somebody that is heavily traumatized, or maybe somebody that's having cancer, or just really, you know, there are bad energies there. I would not put my stones into that force field. I would actually prefer to piggyback it, you know, onto a crystal if I have that, or a wand, and basically squirt this energy from a distance onto the person. I respect my little gems and the little devas too much than to contaminate them like that. Another important principle is that you should purify the rocks or gems before you use them and after you use them. Personally, I prefer the divine symbol for that, but brown rice is good. Water is good. Do not boil them. I would say just room temperature water is fine. Putting them on the earth is good. Putting them into the moonlight is good. Putting them on the salt will work kind of harsh. Then you have no time for any of those. You can just hold them in front of your mouth and think, purify in a loving way, and just blow over them. In a loving way, think, purify, and now for those little guys, it's like taking a shower, and you can kind of feel, you know, how they are, get happier and happier. You know, I treat these little devas here as pets, in a humble way, in a loving way. I never command them. I always ask them politely, and I think that is the way to deal with anybody. I think that is the way we're supposed to be in all levels of creation. Now, before we do any healings, of course, we want to invoke the highest good. for me, my formula, my personal formula is, you know, for this healing and now also for this session here, I asked the highest powers that come from divine love to make sure that everything that comes from this video and from this healing will be for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes only. We don't want any crazy stuff to happen. We don't want anything to be misinterpreted. You know, we all heard those wisdom stories, you know, with people that got three wishes for free, and people wanted, they wanted something good, but, you know, somehow or other they didn't cover all the ground and then it backfired on them. So we don't want this. That's why, for the highest good in divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes, anything that comes from here. And I also ask that any resistances that are there to manifest the highest good and the divine harmony and the most benevolent outcomes through this session here will be removed from now on. Amen. And with this amen, we're coming to another part of important principle, which is, you know, the issue of free will. There are a lot of higher dimensional entities that are like to help, and they need permission. The good guys basically do not interfere with our lives. Everybody kind of knows this principle from Star Trek, the one of non-interference. I will have to give them permission, and the more specific the permission, the more specific they can help. The more general permission, the more washed out basically the results will be. That's the principle. So I will be, you know, in this following healing session, which is of course also a learning session for you, because you will learn the principles, and then you can take it, you know, from then on, just like cooking. You know, you show a basic recipe and then you modify according to your own taste. So I will be using intent, asking, you know, higher powers to assist. And so you do not have to repeat this. Do not be distracted by this. You know, just when I'm done and you agree with it and you want this to apply for you, just think or say amen. And you know, the more emotional, actually, the more you mean it, you know, the more it will work on you. And then after about 2-3 seconds, you will start feeling the results. And as we are talking about higher dimensionals, we all have kind of different belief system. You know, some believe in angels, some are strictly Christians, and some people come from other religious backgrounds. There are bodhisattvas, you know, there is Jesus, there is Mother Mary, Mother Earth is conscious, there are all kinds of beings, and they all can help, they all can help in different ways, they have their specialty, and so I will invoke what I like for myself. You know, I have relationships with many of those beings. I do not see them in general, but I surely can feel their presence. Other people can feel their presence too when they're sensitive, especially women do. Sometimes, you know, certain smells will also, you know, show me that they're there. Like Mother Mary, you know, smells of roses many times. And these are just some examples. But in general, you know, you will feel different in your body or around your body, like a tingling, like a well-being, like an uplifting of your spirit. And that is generally a sign of those beings being there. And those flavors of upliftment and feeling are different than also, you know, just like according to the personalities of those higher dimensionals. Now you can also invoke Source or God. So let's just do this right now. So I asked Archangel Michael to please be present and do security work. Amen. I asked Mother Earth to be present and give her support to me. Amen. I asked my spirit guides to be present. Amen. And my hairs are standing on end now. And I asked my high self to be present and my inner child to be present. And I actually asked my inner child to give permission for this healing, for this video. And I like it to play through me, so I won't be too stiff. Yeah, have more fun. You know, we all want to have fun, and the inner child is the one that helps with the fun. And the higher self is basically my soul, the divine part of me that resides in all the higher dimension, that is completely aware and beyond space of time, my eternal spirit. You know, again, different traditions, different words, pretty much all the same. And I do not promote scholarship. I think that just pushes you on the mental plane. I would say, you know, those things have to be experienced, and then you know. Okay, so I also asked, you know, any bodhisattvas that want to come and help. And the Native American deities of the four direction, actually of the five direction, to come. And I asked all the beings to come and work with the people that are watching this video, with their relationships. Amen. All right. Now I already feel a lot better, and let's talk a little bit more philosophy and understanding. So nowadays, in the Western world at least, where food, especially junk food, is ample, a lot of people do not like their bodies because they get fat. Old age basically has influences of the body, like the mammarian glands go south, the waistline gets bigger, and you know, a lot of us, due to lack of exercise maybe, or other reasons, do not look the way, you know, we want to. And there are certain things to consider here. One, maybe something that you have not heard before, is that you may know, is like in every, you know, in the different cultures, different body shapes, you know, are preferred and other shapes are rejected. This is in general, you know, what is ideal, you know, for procreation at in those circumstances. So in cultures where food is rare, you know, let's say big bodies, voluptuous bodies, like the Venus of Willenberg shapes, Baroque shapes, are preferred. And in cultures where big bodies are a sign of not having great health or maybe lacking in self-discipline, the more athletic or slim bodies are preferred. And of course, you know, everybody that knows a little bit about art history and then history maybe of Europeans, you know, we all probably understand that certain sexual attributes sometimes were, you know, what was considered attractive has changed a lot. You know, there were times where a big bosom was a sign, was vulgar, and so a small breast were considered in, and I felt this has changed nowadays. And the same with the size of the behind, this has changed also dramatically. Just look at the art, look at the skirts, the way they were formed. So basically, whatever body shape you have, in certain cultures, you were probably very hot. And my intuition tells me that in past lives, many of us, have desired very strongly, one of those ideal shapes of that time. And now they got them in this lifetime, and it's outdated. It's just like having an old car model. It's outdated. It's not in anymore. So I would like you to release that. And let's do this all together. Remember the Amen bit. So also please understand that your body has an intelligence of its own. It is a sub-personality of yours. So I'm addressing my body now. Dear body, I apologize to you that I have been judging you. That I've been judging you for the shape that you have. This shape comes maybe from past life desires that I wanted to have this shape because I thought it was good, it was cool. So I release you now from those desires and apologize for judging you for fulfilling those desires. You have done the best you could, and you got nothing but criticism and judgment from me, so I apologize to you now. So please find or remove or clear all those judgments and also those desires to be a certain shape for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. Amen. And I ask that you please reprogram yourself to take the shape that is ideal for your health, your well-being, and for our happiness in this lifetime. Amen. And any resistances to release those programmings, please find or remove or clear all and continue to finish. Amen. And now, as a sign that we really mean it, I'm having those beautiful pink stones in my right hand, so I'm folding my hand over it. And I imagine that I'm drawing the love from heaven and earth into my heart. And on the exhale, I'm just running it through my right hand into the yorks. And then on the next inhale, I just pull it in again and run it through this arm. And then automatically it would push it over to the left. And the heart, because it runs over the heart, will distribute that love all through the body. So we're just loving our body in this way with the help and amplification of the pink stones, especially rose quartz. And we tell our body that we love our body. And our body is kind of like a city with many different cells. Every cell is a household. And your consciousness, your I am consciousness awareness, is the king or queen of the city. And you going around, distributing money, love, to all the different cells now. Amen. And I release any resistances in my body to receive this love and nourishment for me now. Amen. And please keep breathing while I'm talking. So the deeper you breathe, the more powerful the love will be. Try to breathe all the way in and all the way out. Nice, smooth, but all the way in, all the way out. In that way, you learn the proper way of breathing, you maximize the power, and you smile as sweet as you can to maximize the sweetness of the love of the chi that is running through you and into your cells now. And you could maybe go and put those now onto your butt and apologize to your butt. I apologize to you, dear butt, for judging you, for not being the right shape. I apologize for that. Please release all the judgment that you're holding, all the pain of not being appreciated, you know, from this lifetime as well as past lifetimes. Please release all that now for the highest good and divine harmony. Amen. And just run love into those areas. Just imagine you're sending it through your arms, through the stones, into the tissue. And to ask the tissue there to please absorb it and to release any resistances towards absorbing this nice, beautiful, healing love. And to ask also that, you know, the holographic matrix of this area be updated for my highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes now. Okay, and actually my niece, they want to have some recognition here. My niece tend to be cold, and of course many of us develop rheumatism in their old age because knees are cold. Cold tissue means the blood doesn't flush all the toxins out, you know, undernourished area, and I mean, of course it's understandable, there's a lot of bone and cartilage and sinew there, not much blood flowing, so we want to make up and run a lot of love in there. And of course first we ask the niece, you know, whenever you have been hurting and I did not like you for that, I apologize, you know, I should be compassionate with you, and so please, you know, from this lifetime and from past lifetime, you know, please release all those hurts from accidents, from me not appreciating you. And, you know, also knees are not going, wanting to go forward in a psychological way, see Louisa Hayes. So also I release any negative programs about fear of the future, you know, not going forward. I trust into the divine guidance of my high self to guide me in the right way. Amen. Whew, that's a big one here. And I ask that the knees please release any resistance towards receiving love and nourishment. And just run that love into those knees and then, you know, out the feet into the earth. Just like hosing something off with nice warm water. And then the dirty water, the bad chi kind of flows out. And of course I asked the high selves and maybe Archangel Gabriel to please clear out the grounding cords, the nadis, the underground, or sewer out the low chi into the earth. Now, amen. Yep, thank you. Archangels are the best. And they love to interface with gems. And I also ask that my foot chakra is nicely open and be cleared so that I can sewer out negative energy and bring in positive clean energy from Mother Earth to nourish my body and my systems now. Amen. And any blocks from this lifetime and past lifetime, please find out, remove on, clear out, continue to finish. Amen. So most people in the Western world, you know, we drive everywhere, we hang out in front of the computer, sit most of our day in front of computers and in offices or conference rooms, and drive everywhere, go to the parking lot, and that's it. And so we do not have good powerful legs anymore, there's weak aura. So I apologize to my legs for not using them enough anymore. They're probably unhappy about this, you know, from this lifetime and maybe even past lifetime. So please release any stagnant energies there. And I asked Archangel Michael to do a healing and upgrade on my legs, on my energy nadis there. And on the, let's say, Chinese, yeah. Chinese energies pathways too, on all levels. Amen. And let's run the love from the knees down into the earth. And you will, you might feel waves of energy flowing over you. You might feel tingling at different parts of the body. That's a good sign of release of negative energies, of release of blockages, and of the increased flow of energy. So tingling, you know, waves of good energy flowing over you is always a good thing, and it should be appreciated and enjoyed. That's why I'm closing my eyes, so my awareness is on the inside, not on the outside. Of course, as Western people, we are trained to basically focus our awareness mostly on the outside, and inside, we don't look that great. So, if you learned one thing here in this video, besides smiling and projecting love into different parts of your bodies, is, you know, grooming yourself inside and feeling better on the inside. You know, those healings, they're not just one-shot deals. I mean, yeah, they can shift a lot in your health, but if applied more often, like once a week, it's a very good idea. It's just like, you know, you brush your teeth, you know, every day, you take a shower every day, maybe you take a nice hot bath once a week. That's good physical and also emotional and spiritual hygiene, and, you know, doing gem healings, you know, is the same thing. So now let's go to our stomachs, and of course the flat stomach in the Western culture is ideal nowadays. In Japanese culture, you know, a decent man of age has a strong hara, you know, he has a little pot belly. But in this culture, you know, the six-pack is, you know, that is what is considered ideal. So we probably have been judging our bellies a lot. And so first of all, I ask my belly to please release any programming that he has received from past lifetimes and this lifetimes, you know, how I wanted my body to look like. Amen. And any resistances towards release those old programmings, please find or remove on, clear on, continue to finish. And I asked, you know, my body to do this. I asked Archangel Gabriel, the healing angel, to assist with that. Yeah. Well, whenever we get angels involved, you know, energy really starts moving. And we pump love into the whole belly area. So I'm having my hands kind of spread like that. And, you know, start pumping love from heaven and earth into your heart, then through the heart, into the arms, into the stone, into the whole tummy area. And think, I love you, I love you, I love you. And again, I ask my tummy to release the rest of the judgment, whatever is still there. So you can upgrade to the divine blueprint, which is the highest good in this incarnation. And any, please also release any resistances towards releasing those negative energies. And whatever other crap is being held there, you know, stuck emotions, anger, emotions maybe that couldn't be expressed. And, you know, most of you know that a lot of the emotions around power and other things, you know, are held in the gut. You know, the gut is actually very intelligent. It has its own brain. It's different than the brain in the heart, and it's different than the brain in the head. It's more simplified, but it's very accurate, so I appreciate that brain, and I like to take advantage of its knowledge, and I ask that any blocks that I have in myself, you know, to listen to the intelligence of my guts, please be released now. And I ask Archangel Gabriel to help me release those negative programs, the blocks from past lifetime and this lifetime, and to upgrade me for my highest good in divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. Amen. And start pumping love into them. Smile like an idiot and breathe like a bellow. and I also release any programs that I have from this lifetime and past lifetime about hunger, about not getting enough, and about the idea that food equals love. Food is nourishment. If you eat too much, it sucks a lot of energy from you to just digest it. You know, overeating probably zaps 70 to 80% of the energy of Western man. That's why fasting is such a good idea. So please release any misconceptions that I'm holding about food for my tummy and my emotional and lower emotional bodies now. Amen. And I release any resistances towards releasing those programs, and I ask for the assistance of Archangel Michael, of Archangel Gabriel, and of Archangel Metatron. Archangel Metatron is the one in charge of ascension and releasing this old stuff, negative programming or outdated programming, helps in ascension, so, oh yeah. It works. And you will feel, I mean, you will probably feel certain sensations, and the more of the sensations that you can see or feel, you know, the more you know that stuff is actually happening. It's not just all, you know, hocus pocus, mumbo jumbo. And I also release any power, negative power programming, you know, lording over others, programming that is outdated, and ask that from now on the intelligence of the solaris plexus of my intestines and the intelligence of my heart will work together in divine harmony. Amen. Say amen. And I also ask that any resistances towards this connection, please find or release or clear all from past lives and lifetimes and this lifetimes. Amen. So now I'm putting all the stones on my heart chakra. Actually, the fine strawberry or Scots cross on the higher heart chakra, you know, which is kind of the thymus area. And I release any self-judgment and condemnations that I'm still holding in my heart for mistakes I've made from this lifetime and past lifetime. All my intents is always related to past lifetimes, this lifetime, and hey, let's put in parallel lifetimes too. Amen. From now on. And I also release any fear of love, you know, from previous, you know, bad memories, you know, rejected love, lost love through accidents, death, separation, wrong caste, you know, already married to the wrong person. Pfft, lots of reasons why we got hurt, you know, love, you know, broken heart. Yeah, let's call it the broken heart. So I release any memories, any wounds from broken hearts. Amen. And any resistances also to release those traumas from broken heart. Amen. And I ask Archangel Gabriel to please help with the healing and the expertise of Mother Mary to help out. You know, Mother Mary is really good with the heart. Oh yeah. That love is just awesome from her. I also release any curses from past life and this lifetimes, and any vows that I've done, you know, maybe to maintain celibacy, you know, to decrease my capacity for love. Amen. And any resistances towards releasing those blocks towards love from myself and all the different levels of my being. Now, amen. Whew. Okay, now these points here, they're like where the pecs kind of attach to the bone, you know, and you press there, you know, you feel really sore spots there, here and here. These are the access points, you know, for your lungs and where there is sadness stored and a lot of abandonment issues. Are stored there too. So, you know, with your stones and your palms, you know, you just cross your arms. It, what a lovely to that. And I release any issues of abandonment from this lifetime and past lifetimes. And I ask the healing angels, Mother Mary, to help me, assist me. Amen. And just keep breathing, and if you have to cry, that's really good. Just go with it. It's a sign of very strong purification. And we probably all had issues of abandonment, so. Release any resistances to release this pain. And, you know, there are issues of abandonment from little, as when we were little children. Sometimes we were just abandoned for a night. Maybe we were lost. Died or sold to slavery. Our parents died. Our parents didn't like us. Our lovers didn't like us. You know, or left us for somebody else, for somebody better. Through all our lifetimes, you know, we all had issues like that. And it doesn't help to carry that crap around without that pain. So I release all that. The angels, please pull it out of me. Mother Mary, please pull it out of me. Amen. And of course, there's also the abandonment of spirit that we experienced, that the light workers that got tortured from the Inquisition, that got tortured from their Pharisees and rabbis. I mean, religious persecution has been going on in all traditions, I guess. I don't want to point any fingers. That is not the point. The point is to let go of it. Doesn't mean that what was done to us was right. Nothing to do with that. It's just we don't want to carry that pain with us anymore. So we become clear and pure vessels of love of God. Pure, happy instruments of God. If you have asthma, this is a real good one. That should be very powerful for you. and I ask that the divine blueprint of my lungs be updated. Amen. And any resistance for the updated being released. Amen. Okay, now the next part is, of course, our neck, the throat. And I release any instances from past, from the past, where my personal divine expression was not accepted from others or from myself, where I got into trouble, and where I was condemned from others, or where I condemned myself. Some of us spoke the truth in front of authorities and bad things started to happen to us, or we spoke up to our parents or authorities as little kids and bad things happened to us, and because bad things happened to us, maybe and to our loved ones, we condemned this free expression, this free joyful expression of our higher truth. And it's a big loss. So first of all, I release all the trauma that I'm still holding in this areas and around these issues from past lifetimes and this lifetime. Now, amen. And I release any resistances towards releasing those issues from this and past lives. Now, amen. And I asked Archangel Michael and Archangel Metatron and Archangel Gabriel to assist with us. Amen. I'm including Archangel Archangel Michael in this because he deals with the black magic, with the implants that have been put in there from ETs, from magicians, demons. And as we are there, yes, please remove any astral and other implants from this area that has been placed there by ETs, magicians, demons, ghosts, other entities. Doesn't matter from where. It's an infringement on free will, and that's why I asked it to be removed for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. And I ask the same for my heart chakra, for my solar plexus, for my whole being, that any infringement, you know, through implantation and black magic devices, please be removed from my whole system. Amen. And any resistances towards removing those, please find those too. Amen. Oof. You know, sometimes you will feel, you know, your body wants to move, clear out. This I consider clears, and just go with it. It helps release energy, blocked energy. Breathe into the area. Take the stones again. Let's do front and back. I love you. And please release any blocks in my throat area, in my neck area, towards receiving love and nourishment. Okay. And I ask that from now on, I will be able, and I give myself permission to speak my higher truth whenever it is appropriate. and for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes, and any resistances that are still in me from past lifetimes and this lifetime towards expressing my highest truth that can be expressed at those moments, please find or move on, clear or continue to finish, especially Archangel Metatron and Gabriel. Please do that. And let's deal with this area here. You know, this is the mental plane. That's where judgment comes in. Thought, abstract thought, not direct experience, just the abstract. You know, it's a good tool. But, you know, as yogis or religious spiritual people, you know, you're supposed to reside here, not here. That's for scholars or preachers that have no realization. You know, they go here. They're like eunuchs. Licking the jar of honey? No, I got that messed up, but you know what I mean. You know, real spirituality, you know, happens in the heart. And that's where you connect with the divine, through the heart, through the purity of the heart. That just helps you maybe to sort things out. So, but it has a lot of effect on us. So, I ask that my third eye, front and back, be released, be cleared from all blocks, especially blocks that prevent it to see the love in things. You know, the love of God, the love of nature, the love that's manifested everywhere. And all the programming and conditioning from past lifetimes and this lifetime that prevent me from seeing this. Please find all and move on, clear, or continue to finish. Amen. And I also ask that from now on, my negative thoughts will be replaced by positive, loving thoughts. I mean, you all guys, you all know. You know, if you think negative thoughts, you start feeling bad. If you think angry thoughts, you start feeling angry, and if you think loving and grateful thoughts, you know, you feel loving and grateful. So, you know, that's what we ask for. Beautiful, positive thoughts that will help us in our evolution and our happiness and our ascension. Amen. And any resistances towards releasing those, peace, find or move on, clear or continue. Placing those gems now. Thank you so much for helping me. I'm placing them on the divine symbol so they get purified. And now I'm taking my wand and putting my finger on the water cross sign here. Hold it in front of me, move it through the crown chakra. Please make my crown chakra a channel of higher dimensional love. Now I'm piggybacking the quartz crystal, now the rose quartz crystal. Whew. I love that. Whew. And again, enjoy this experience for yourself. And ask Archangel Gabriel and Metatron to please remove, find or remove on Creole any resistances in my crown chakra. And Archangel Michael, please remove, find or remove on Creole any implants black magic devices in our crown chakra that are designed to limit and control us in. And that we may not be implanted again. Amen. Never ever against our will, against our highest interest. And I ask that a beautiful column of light, healing pink light, just flow all over me, supplemented by energies and colors that I need, that will update me, that will heal me, that will help in my ascension, in my purification, and my well-being, helping me to manifest in this lifetime whatever I came to manifest as a service. Amen. And any resistances to this happening, please find or remove on, clear out, and continue to finish. Amen. Thank you, my friends, for being with me through the session. Please support this work through liking it, also through writing positive comments, you know, through subscribing to the channel, through sharing it on Facebook and other social media, and also, you know, through giving me support through donations. So I can devote more of my life, you know, to this work, because I have to pay the bills like everybody else, and if there are no donations, I have to work a normal job like everybody else, and cannot produce more video and do healing sessions with other people. You know, you vote with your money. Wisely. I love you. I hope you enjoyed it. That you will be protected and guided for your highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes from now on. Namaste. Oh, Thank you.
Thank you.